watching HTN, Herricks Television Network Sports.
Hello viewers, this is the Herricks 2023 Homecoming. Let us start with the Homecoming Parade. Enjoy.
We need to act it out.
Well.
Can you move that cone a little bit to his left so you can see it again? Cone for the cone.
Thank you.
Welcome, Herricks students and staff. Who's ready for pep rally? On this beautiful homecoming Friday, pep rally is a tradition to honor the hard work, dedication, and commitment to sport that these student athletes have put forth. And without further ado, here we go, Herricks. First up, we have boys varsity golf, coached by Mike DePasso, with captains Gabe Owen and Jake Moon. Varsity golf team had another great season, came out of the gate on fire, won four out of their first five matches. They're led by captains Jake Moon and Gabe Owen. Because of the team's hard work this season, they're sending several players to counties and are still eligible for playoffs in May. All right, golf. Next up, boys varsity badminton. Led by Coach Misurisi, captains Micah Yu, Aaron Chu, and Aiden Lee. The boys varsity badminton team has maintained a strong record this season, 9-1. And they have their eyes set on being conference champs once again. Led by their captains Micah Yu, Aaron Chu, and Aiden Lee, the team is paving their way to the top. It all comes down to their big game on Monday. Next up, boys and girls, varsity cross country, led by coaches Joe Caruso and Doug Kramer. Captains Julia Yam and Vinny Shaw. The cross country team is off to a great start, with many veterans providing leadership. The team has had much success. The team is working hard and improving week by week. We're preparing for the Nassau County Championships on October 28th at Bethpage State Park. Run fast, team. Next up, girls varsity swimming. Head by coach Daniel Sullivan and Joe Morrow. Captain Sumi Molina, Jamie Chung, Isabella Chang, and Ellie Wu. The girls varsity swimming and diving team has started off the year strong with several victories, county qualifiers, and state qualifiers. They've been working hard both in and out of the pool to improve their strokes and are looking forward to their division championship meet at the end of October. Yes, women. Girls JV tennis is up next. Head by the legend Ray Cross. Captains Brianna Pai and Ashish Shah. The JV girls tennis team, where every match feels like a family reunion and every point is fueled by unbeatable spirit. They're not just a team, they're a tennis-loving family. Next up, we have girls varsity tennis. Led by Coach Joy Solomon, Captains Chloe Kim and Nikita Kumar. This year's team is led by co-captains Chloe Kim and Nikita Kumar. Herricks dominates on the court with a current record of 8-3. Even though Mother Nature has not been kind to the season, the team has shown resilience and perseverance against not just the weather, but the fiercest of teams. We look forward to the rest of the season and we wish our girls the best of luck. Next up, we have girls JV cheer, led by Coach Bettina Kuliapaku, Captains Brianna Wong, Madison Nell, and Richin Mernsang. The JV cheerleaders show the true meaning of love and dedication for a sport. Rain or shine, these girls are out on the sidelines cheering on our JV football team with ease. During practice, these girls exemplified not only advanced skills, but love and respect for one another. This team should be extremely proud of themselves and what they've accomplished in just a few short weeks together. Go JV cheer! All right, next up, we're going to have our varsity cheerleaders. Here they come. Coach Chiara Marangeli, as well as Captain Sophia Cooney, Alexia Rinaldo, Kelly Orlando, and Ellie Lambros lead the squad. This year's varsity cheerleading team has shown the many qualities of what it means to be a part of a team. The respect for each other and the love for the sport have come together to bring out the best of each athlete. For the first time ever in Herricks cheerleading history, the varsity team is participating in a new competition called Game Day Competition. Teams are judged on execution, crowd effectiveness, energy, and overall performance. It gives the team the opportunity to demonstrate and involve school traditions like music from our Herricks band. This team has been persevering through each practice to create a fantastic crowd effective routine. We're looking forward to see where the game day competition takes us. And crowd, you are in for a treat, because at this point we want to call up the JV and varsity cheer squads to perform one of their numbers. Let's just have a minute and let the girls set up and get moving. Apologies, this is just the varsity dance. Do you guys want it loud? Is that loud enough for your Herricks? Let's give one more cheer for the cheer team! Come out tonight, we can sing good again! Alright, if you like dancing, you're in for a treat, because we have the Herricks Dance Theater Club performing a routine for you right now. Let go, Miss Lindsay Quinqua. Don't you dare call them not a sport. This is a dance squad ready to go.
Give it up your body, give it up your body. At the end of this year at their annual show, so come on out and see them. The Dance Theater Club will also be performing a different act before the game tonight, around 5:15, so come on out, get here early. All right, back to the program. Next up, Herricks Girls JV Volleyball. Led by Coach Suzanne Kenny, Captains Ashley Shue, Bella Liao, and Brooke Lynn. The girls' JV volleyball team is currently 5-4 on the year. They continue to work and grow and develop their skills as a team and as individuals. Their hard work and commitment is a great sign of things to come. Go JV volleyball! Next up, we have Girls Varsity Volleyball, led by Coach Tara Krinsky and Coach Emily Markakis. Captains Tara Flood and Melanie Rakitovan. The Varsity Girls Volleyball team is currently 4-6. Despite the strong competitive nature of this year's conference, the Herricks team's spirit continues to grow stronger each match. The girls are showing their true Highlander energy in each and every match. With a strong, dynamic group of players, we are confident on the upcoming victories for the team. Next week, both matches will be home, so come check out the fiery competition. Great things are on the horizon for this year's team. Go Varsity Volleyball! All right, next on tap, we have Boys JV Soccer, led by Coach Scott Elsoff. The JV boys soccer team has been competitive and fought hard in every game this year. Captains Michael Fernandez, Michael Zhang, Grace Lago, and Angelo Fidel are leading in the spirit and the energy, and then outstanding players throughout the season have been Zion Tom, Jaden Pineda, Luis Gonzalez, Ocean Howe,
Amon Rad, Ibrahim Hamuda, and Darcel Jabari. Yes, soccer. Next up, we have boys varsity soccer. Led by coach Adriana Mandrinos and assistant coach Gordon Purdy, with captains Adel Bakovic, Christos Kathis, and Peter Leckergaren. The varsity boys soccer team epitomizes unity, hard work, and resilience. They're a close-knit family on and off the field, always keeping their heads up and working together as one unstoppable force. Let's give it up as they kind of swag flex right past us here. Don't let the lack of emotion fool you. That soccer team is serious business. All right. Without further ado, let's see the boys JV volleyball team. Coach Carl Drago leads a squad headed by captains Aaron Chick, Matthew Chang, and Krish Gopal. The boys JV volleyball team has had a successful season so far with a 6-4 overall record. They have worked hard each and every day and continue to get better as the season goes on. The future is bright for this talented group of young men. And it looks like they like to have a great time, doesn't it, folks? Next up, boys varsity volleyball. Coach Craig Grinder and assistant coach Jason Smith lead the squad with captains Shreya Stott, Evan Liao, Devin Lee, Dylan Lee, Brandon Moy, and Tristan Serge Bali. The boys volleyball team currently has a record of 8-2 and holds the number 3 seed among large schools in Nassau County. 8-2. Their success can be attributed to everyone working together as a cohesive unit. They have gotten significant contributions from a variety of players. Please come support us for a huge game against Playview JFK on October 23rd and Senior Night versus Farmingdale on October 26th. Herricks will also be hosting the playoff quarterfinals on Halloween. Please stop by to cheer them on before going out to trick or treat. Next up, girls JV soccer, led by coach Rich Basilia. This team has no captains because everyone matters. The JV girls soccer team has been super competitive this season. Each game has been a battle, and the girls have consistently answered the bell. We're looking forward to a strong finish. Let's go, JV soccer! Next up, we have a squad loaded with talent, girls varsity soccer, led by coach Alexa Regal and assistant coach Stephanie Brennan. Also led by captains Maggie Ledwith, Ava Lorenzana, and Christiana Kulega. The girls have been battling all season long in a very competitive conference. We're looking to get some wins on the road for our last two games. We have 16 seniors ready for their last chance at a title. Round one of the playoffs are on October 23rd, and we're hoping to host. Come support girls soccer! Yeah, let's get another round of applause for the girls! Next up, it's your boys' JV football team, led by Coach Warren Webster and assistant coach Eric Goldberg. Captains Yanni Dulis, James Maggio, and Charles Eddy. The 2023 JV football team has a record of 1-3 currently. Respect all, fear none. Not how hard you start, but how you finish. Come see the team away at Roslyn on Monday. One more cheer for JV football! Okay, next up, we have the boys' varsity football team! Led by Coach Tom Grafe and assistant coaches Ken Davis, Chris DeVeo, and Steve Formicelli. Also led by captains Ethan Tran, Brian Keating, Connor Griffith, and Aaron Oman. Almost 50 strong, the Herricks varsity football team is currently 1-4, heading into tonight's big game. On offense, we've been led by senior Ethan Tran, as well as juniors Aziz Cameron and Aaron Oman, who total over 700 yards and 11 touchdowns combined. Our defense has been led by seniors Connor Griffith and Thomas Gaudier. Our best game so far this season was a dominating performance against Jericho High School, where they were up 42-0 at the half. They're excited to play tonight in front of the best crowd and community in Nassau County. That's you, Herricks! Just for reference, everyone, we have a homecoming parade tonight, starting outside the tech room at 4:30. Everyone is welcome to join, so come on out and show your Herricks spirit. You can march with your class. We're going to come on down to the field, and we have a great pre-game show for you with the game starting tonight at 5:30 under the lights. Go Highlanders. Okay, at this point, I'd like to call the classes out with their banners, so we can go ahead and see the hard work and energy that the classes have put in. As you know, that's right, let's go, all four classes, let's head out to the front of the field there. Come on, bring your banners out. Last night was banner night, we had a great time. A lot of energy and spirit was shown. Students, student government is for everyone. And you are welcome to get involved, share your voice, join their meetings on Thursdays, and be a part of what's your high school experience. What we have now are the banners that were created for each class, as well as the plaques. which are the first battle points of the year. So getting involved and helping with this helps your team win battle points and eventually grabbing that battle bowl at the end of the year. The seniors have taken the battle bowl for the past few years. Is it possible that maybe the freshmen, sophomores, or juniors could pry it from their claws this year? Column two. There you go. All right. So, just to be clear, these banners have been voted on by administration, including Superintendent Dr. Tony Sinanis. The winners will be announced at halftime of the game. So listen up, and hopefully your team will become first in battle points. Here's the story behind the freshman banner. Freshman, hold your banner up, freshman. Let's go, freshman. Cheer for the freshman. Come on. In the middle of the night, at the darkest time, the wind howls with the flutter of bats and the shrieks of the undead. Lightning streaks through the sky. The earth rumbles as a monster awakens. Towering over mortals, limbs and bolts cranking, Frankenstein for zone roars to life. Roar! Far away in a forgotten fortress, zombies wake to the thundering of hooves. Headless Hodge bursts out, a beheaded specter of shadows, holding his head high, smiling menacingly. High in the sky, the moon shines a deep shade of red. Animals and souls alike bow as the Queen of Spirits rises. Long live Crazy Keegan, supreme ruler of all! All right, freshmen, nice job! Everyone cheer for the freshmen! We were all there once, right? That was great. All right. Sophomores, hold up your banner. Oh, there the sophomores are. They've been here before. Turns out the sophomores are poets as well. It was the night before homecoming when Hodge Skellington, Boogie Frizzone, and Sally Keegan debuted on this spooky banner. Surrounded by vibrant pumpkins, a blinding moon, and other things of fright, these monsters are excited to see us beat Roslyn tonight! All right, sophomores! That's a beautiful banner right there. Just a historical note, sophomores have always put a strong showing in a battle, so watch out, juniors and seniors. It's a thing. They're giant killers. All right, here's the junior banner. Juniors, hold it up high. Step into the spine-tingling world of the Monster High Mansion. Our banner unveils a realm where all your frightful fantasies come to life. Encounter several different of our favorite monsters as the eerie mansion and inhabitants come alive in detail. Get ready to be spooked as you explore this spine-tingling abode of the supernatural. Dare to enter and experience the frights that await within. All right, juniors! That's right, let's go! All right, seniors. The crew holding this banner needs your support. No pun intended, but they were a skeleton crew last night, so we will need some more participation from the seniors throughout the year, all right? All right. That's it. Yeah, seniors, come on! One spooky homecoming night, the seniors were put under a spell. The spell allowed the seniors to see all sorts of creatures. As the seniors made their way to the bleachers, they were stopped by monsters. Mike Wazowski and Sully ran up to the students and collected their screams. Mavis and Dracula flew down from the sky and taught the class how to turn into bats. Frankenstein, Freddy, and the Demogorgon made their way to the football team. to chase and chase the team, driving them all the way into the end zone. As much as the Monsters love the seniors, they don't feel the same towards the underclassmen. Beware! That's messed up, underclassmen. All right. All right, so now, I want to hear it by cheers. Who likes the freshman banner the most? What about the sophomore banner? Hear that? I'm telling you, watch out for the sophomores. What about the junior banner? All right, that's it for the day. No, we like the senior banner! All right, well, they're all great, and you're all great. Can we get one more huge cheer for all these student athletes? That's right! Let's go, Herricks! All right, so at this point, I have a couple announcements to make. Any staff and faculty that is here, we'd ask that you please come out to the field at the end because we'd like to get a little photo in this beautiful weather. And then at this point, so we have some time here, folks, we want to make an orderly exit. So what we'd like to do is ask the freshmen to leave first. Can we have the freshman class please exit the stands? Everyone else is going to get out of here in time. Just enjoy the weather. Once again, everyone, the game, the festivities tonight start at 4:45 with a parade down the hill. Everyone can join your class behind these beautiful banners and walk on down. 5:00, we're honoring our senior cheerleaders and football players, as well as having their parents out on the field. Beautiful ceremony. You don't want to miss. After that, we have our Harris Dance Theater Club performing once more, a different tune, a different number, out on the field, 5:10. At 5:15, we're honoring our Highlander 10. For the underclassmen who don't know what the Highlander 10 are, these students exemplify everything that Harris spirit, Harris pride, and the Harris way, and they are voted by their peers, so it's something that everyone should aspire to. One of the best honors we can bestow on any of our students. Sophomores, where are you going? Just take it easy. Slow down.
Hello. Sophomores, walk around. You're going to go down behind the juniors over here towards the show for our crew. Freshmen all the way at the end, sophomores, juniors, seniors are closer to the school. Next to the juniors. Yep. All right, freshmen, just walk down the track and all the way to the end, all right? Sophomores, you can use this middle staircase here, too. The far side closest to the school is the senior section. Then juniors, then sophomores. Freshmen are far down towards Shelter Rock Road. That far section towards the school is the senior section. You guys seniors there on top row? Yeah. Sophomores, if you're out of room, you can fill in the front here with the juniors. There's a bunch of rows right here in the front. Fill right in. Mr. Cavett, have them fill in right here. These seats right here are open, guys. Perfect. Have a seat. All right, seniors, you're right here. Closest to the school. Fill in the stands right here, seniors. Thank you. All right, let's get in the stands, everyone. Let's go, seniors. Let's get in there. Everyone's all right to just find a seat at this point. Welcome, Herricks students and staff. Who's ready for pep rally? On this beautiful homecoming Friday, pep rally is a tradition to honor the hard work, dedication, and commitment to sport that these student athletes have put forth. And without further ado, here we go, Herricks. First up, we have boys varsity golf, coached by Mike DePasso, with captains Gabe O and Jake Moon. Varsity golf team had another great season, came out of the gate on fire, and won four out of their first five matches. They're led by captains Jake Moon and Gabe O. Because of the team's hard work this season, they're sending several players to counties and are still eligible for playoffs in May. All right, go! Next up, boys varsity badminton, led by Coach Misurisi, captains Micah Yu, Aaron Chu, and Aiden Lee. The boys varsity badminton team has maintained a strong record this season, 9-1. And they have their eyes set on being conference champs once again. Led by their captains, Micah Yu, Aaron Chu, and Aiden Lee, the team is paving their way to the top. It all comes down to their big game on Monday. Next up, boys and girls, varsity cross country. Led by coaches Joe Caruso and Doug Kramer. Captains Julia Yam and Vinny Shaw. The cross country team is off to a great start. With many veterans providing leadership, the team has had much success. The team is working hard and improving week by week. We're preparing for the Nassau County Championships on October 28th at Bethpage State Park. Run fast, team. Next up, girls varsity swimming. Head by coach Daniel Sullivan and Joe Morrow. Captain Sumi Molina, Jamie Chung, Isabella Chang, and Ellie Wu. The girls varsity swimming and diving team has started off the year strong with several victories, county qualifiers and state qualifiers. They've been working hard both in and out of the pool to improve their strokes and are looking forward to their division championship meet at the end of October. Yes, women. Girls JV tennis is up next. Hit by the legend Ray Cross, Captains Brianna Pai and Ashish Shah. The JV girls tennis team, where every match feels like a family reunion and every point is fueled by unbeatable spirit. They're not just a team, they're a tennis-loving family. Next up, we have girls varsity tennis. Led by Coach Joy Solomon, Captains Chloe Kim and Nikita Kumar. This year's team is led by co-captains Chloe Kim and Nikita Kumar. Herricks dominates on the court with a current record of 8-3. Even though Mother Nature has not been kind to the season, the team has shown resilience and perseverance against not just the weather, but the fiercest of teams. We look forward to the rest of the season and we wish our girls the best of luck. Next up, we have girls JV cheer, led by Coach Bettina Kuliapaku, Captains Brianna Wong, Madison Nell, and Richin Mernsang. The JV cheerleaders show the true meaning of love and dedication for a sport. Rain or shine, these girls are out on the sidelines cheering on our JV football team with ease. During practice, these girls exemplified not only advanced skills, but love and respect for one another. This team should be extremely proud of themselves and what they've accomplished in just a few short weeks together. Go JV cheer! All right, next up, we're going to have our varsity cheerleaders. Here they come. Coach Chiara Marangeli, as well as Captain Sophia Cooney, Alexia Rinaldo, Kelly Orlando, and Ellie Lambros, lead the squad. This year's varsity cheerleading team has shown the many qualities of what it means to be a part of a team. The respect for each other and the love for the sport have come together to bring out the best of each athlete. For the first time ever in Herricks cheerleading history, the varsity team is participating in a new competition called Game Day Competition. Teams are judged on execution, crowd effectiveness, energy, and overall performance. It gives the team the opportunity to demonstrate and involve school traditions like music from our Herricks band. This team has been persevering through each practice to create a fantastic crowd effective routine. We're looking forward to see where the Game Day Competition takes us. And crowd, you are in for a treat, because at this point, we want to call up the JV and varsity cheer squads to perform one of their numbers. And let's just have a minute and let the girls set up and get moving. Apologies, this is just the varsity dance. Do you guys want it loud? Is that loud enough for you, Herricks? Let's give one more cheer for the cheer team! Come out tonight, we can soon do it again! Alright, if you like dancing, you're in for a treat because we have the Herricks Dance Theater Club performing a routine for you right now. Led by Miss Lindsay Quinqua. Don't you dare call them not a sport. This is a dance squad ready to go. At the end of this year at their annual show, so come on out and see them. The Dance Theater Club will also be performing a different act before the game tonight around 5:15, so come on out, get here early. All right, back to the program.
Next up, Herricks girls JV volleyball, led by Coach Suzanne Kenny. Captains Ashley Hsu, Bella Liao, and Brooke Lynn. The girls JV volleyball team is currently 5-4 on the year. They continue to work and grow and develop their skills as a team and as individuals. Their hard work and commitment is a great sign of things to come. Go JV volleyball! Next up, we have girls varsity volleyball, led by Coach Tara Krinsky and Coach Emily Markakis. Captains Tara Flood and Melanie Rakitovan. The varsity girls volleyball team is currently 4-6. Despite the strong competitive nature of this year's conference, the Herricks team spirit continues to grow stronger each match. The girls are showing their true Highlander energy in each and every match. With a strong, dynamic group of players, we are confident on the upcoming victories for the team. Next week, both matches will be home, so come check out the fiery competition. Great things are on the horizon for this year's team. Go Varsity Volleyball! All right, next on tap, we have boys JV Soccer, led by Coach Scott Elsoff. The JV boys soccer team has been competitive and fought hard in every game this year. Captains Michael Fernandez, Michael Zhang, Grace Lago, and Angelo Fidel are leading in the spirit and the energy, and then outstanding players throughout the season have been Zion Tom, Jaden Pineda, Luis Gonzalez, Ocean Howe, Amon Rad, Ibrahim Hamuda, and Darshil Javeri. Yeah, soccer. Next up, we have boys varsity soccer, led by Coach Adriana Mandrinos and assistant coach Gordon Purdy, with captains Edel Bakovic, Christos Kathis, and Peter Lecker-Garin. The varsity boys soccer team epitomizes unity, hard work, and resilience. They're a close-knit family on and off the field, always keeping their heads up and working together as one unstoppable force. Let's give it up as they kind of swag flex right past us here. Don't let the lack of emotion fool you. That soccer team is serious business. All right. Without further ado, let's see the boys JV volleyball team. Coach Carl Drago leads a squad headed by captains Aaron Chick, Matthew Chang, and Trish Gopal. The boys JV volleyball team has had a successful season so far with a 6-4 overall record. They have worked hard each and every day and continue to get better as the season goes on. The future's bright for this talented group of young men. And it looks like they like to have a great time, doesn't it, folks? Next up, boys varsity volleyball. Coach Craig Grinder and assistant coach Jason Smith lead the squad with captains Shreya Stott, Evan Liao, Devin Lee, Dylan Lee, Brandon Moy, and Tristan Serge Bali. The boys volleyball team currently has a record of 8-2 and holds the number 3 seed among large schools in Nassau County. 8-2. Their success can be attributed to everyone working together as a cohesive unit. They've gotten significant contributions from a variety of players.
Please come support us for a huge game against Playview JFK on October 23rd and Senior Night versus Farmingdale on October 26th. Herricks will also be hosting the playoff quarterfinals on Halloween. Please stop by to cheer them on before going out to trick or treat. Next up, girls JV soccer, led by Coach Rich Bazilia. This team has no captains because everyone matters. The JV girls soccer team has been super competitive this season. Each game has been a battle, and the girls have consistently answered the bell. We're looking forward to a strong finish. Let's go, JV soccer! Next up, we have a squad loaded with talent, Girls Varsity Soccer, led by Coach Alexa Regal and Assistant Coach Stephanie Brennan. Also led by Captains Maggie Ledwith, Ava Lorenzana, and Christiana Kulega. The girls have been battling all season long in a very competitive conference. We're looking to get some wins on the road for our last two games. We have 16 seniors ready for their last chance at a title. Round one of the playoffs are on October 23rd, and we're hoping to host. Come support girls soccer! Yeah, let's give another round of applause for the girls! Next up, it's your boys JV football team, led by Coach Warren Webster and Assistant Coach Eric Goldberg. Captains Yanni Dulis, James Maggio, and Charles Hurdy. The 2023 JV football team has a record of 1-3 currently. Respect all, fear none. Not how hard you start, but how you finish. Come see the team away at Roslyn on Monday. One more cheer for JV football! Okay, next up, we have the boys varsity football team! Led by Coach Tom Grafe and assistant coaches Ken Davis, Chris Padeo, and Steve Formicelli. Also led by captains Ethan Tran, Brian Keating, Connor Griffith, and Aaron Oman. Almost 50 strong. The Herricks varsity football team is currently 1-4, heading into tonight's big game. On offense, we've been led by senior Ethan Tran, as well as juniors Aziz Cameron and Aaron Oman.
who total over 700 yards and 11 touchdowns combined. Our defense has been led by seniors Connor Griffith and Thomas Gallagher. Our best game so far this season was a dominating performance against Jericho High School, where they were up 42-0 at the half. They're excited to play tonight in front of the best crowd and community in Nassau County. That's you, Herricks! Just for reference, everyone, we have a homecoming parade tonight, starting outside the tech room at 4:30. Everyone is welcome to join, so come on out and show your Herrick spirit. You can march with your class. We're going to come on down to the field, and we have a great pregame show for you with the game starting tonight at 5:30 under the lights. Go Highlanders. Okay, at this point, I'd like to call the classes out with their banners so we can go ahead and see the hard work and energy that the classes have put in. As you know, that's right, let's go, all four classes, let's head out to the front of the field there. Come on, bring your banners out. Last night was banner night, we had a great time. A lot of energy and spirit were shown. Students, student government is for everyone, and you are welcome to get involved, share your voice, join their meetings on Thursdays, and be a part of what's your high school experience. What we have now are the banners that were created for each class, as well as the plaques, which are the first battle points of the year. So getting involved and helping with this helps your team win battle points, and eventually grabbing that battle ball at the end of the year. The seniors have taken the Battle Bowl for the past few years. Is it possible that maybe the freshmen, sophomores, or juniors could pry it from their claws this year? Column two. There you go. All right. So, just to be clear, these banners have been voted on by administration, including Superintendent Dr. Tony Sinanis. The winners will be announced at halftime of the game. So listen up, and hopefully your team will become first in battle points. Here's the story behind the freshman banner. Freshman, hold your banner up, freshman. Let's go, freshman. Cheer for the freshman. Come on. In the middle of the night, at the darkest time, the wind howls with the flutter of bats and the shrieks of the undead. Lightning streaks through the sky. The earth rumbles as a monster awakens. Towering over mortals, limbs and bolts cranking, Frankenstein for zone roars to life. Roar! Far away in a forgotten fortress, zombies wake to the thundering of hooves. Headless Hodge bursts out, a beheaded specter of shadows holding his head high, smiling menacingly. High in the sky, the moon shines a deep shade of red. Animals and souls alike bow as the Queen of Spirits rises. Long live Crazy Keegan, supreme ruler of all! All right, freshmen, nice job! Everyone, cheer for the freshmen! We were all there once, right? That was great. All right. Sophomores, hold up your banner. Oh, there the sophomores are. They've been here before. Turns out the sophomores are poets as well. It was the night before homecoming when Hodge Skellington, Boogie Frizzone, and Sally Keegan debuted on this spooky banner. Surrounded by vibrant pumpkins, a blinding moon, and other things of fright, these monsters are excited to see us beat Roslyn tonight! All right, sophomores! That's a beautiful banner right there. Just
just a historical note, sophomores have always put a strong showing in a battle, so watch out, juniors and seniors. It's a thing. They're giant killers. All right, here's the junior banner. Juniors, hold it up high. Step into the spine-tingling world of the Monster High Mansion. Our banner unveils a realm where all your frightful fantasies come to life. Encounter several different of our favorite monsters as the eerie mansion and inhabitants come alive in detail. Get ready to be spooked as you explore this spine-tingling abode of the supernatural. Dare to enter and experience the frights that await within. All right, juniors! That's right, let's go! All right, seniors, the crew holding this banner needs your support. No pun intended, but they were a skeleton crew last night, so we will need some more participation from the seniors throughout the year, all right? All right. That's it. Yeah, seniors, come on! One spooky homecoming night, the seniors were put under a spell. The spell allowed the seniors to see all sorts of creatures. As the seniors made their way to the bleachers, they were stopped by monsters. Mike Wazowski and Sully ran up to the students and collected their screams. Mavis and Dracula flew down from the sky and taught the class how to turn into bats. Frankenstein, Freddy, and the Demogorgon made their way to the football team. They chased and chased the team, driving them all the way into the end zone. As much as the monsters love the seniors, they don't feel the same towards the underclassmen. Beware! That's messed up, underclassmen. All right. All right, so now, I want to hear it by cheers. Who likes the freshman banner the most? What about the sophomore banner? Hear that? I'm telling you, watch out for the sophomores. What about the junior banner? Yeah! All right, that's it for the day. No, we like the senior banner! All right, well, they're all great, and you're all great. Can we get one more huge cheer for all these student athletes? That's right. Let's go, Herricks. All right, so at this point, I have a couple announcements to make. Any staff or faculty that is here, we'd ask that you please come out to the field at the end because we'd like to get a little photo in this beautiful weather. And then at this point, so we have some time here, folks. We want to make an orderly exit. So what we'd like to do is ask the freshmen to leave first. Can we have the freshman class please exit the stands? Everyone else is going to get out of here in time. Just enjoy the weather. Once again, everyone, the festivities tonight start at 4:45 with a parade down the hill. Everyone can join your class behind these beautiful banners and walk on down. 5:00, we're honoring our senior cheerleaders and football players, as well as having their parents out on the field. Beautiful ceremony. You don't want to miss. After that, we have our Herricks Dance Theater Club performing once more, a different tune, a different number, out on the field, 5:10. At 5:15, we're honoring our Highlander 10. For the underclassmen who don't know what the Highlander 10 are, these students exemplify
everything that Herrick's spirit, Herrick's pride, and the Herrick's way, and they are voted by their peers. So it's something that everyone should aspire to. One of the best honors we can bestow on any of our students. Sophomores, where are you going? Just take it easy. Slow down.
We also have Dr. Tony Sinanis, Superintendent of Schools, Elizabeth Gerson, Assistant Superintendent for Instruction, Lisa Rakowski, Assistant Superintendent for Business, Dina Maggiacomo, Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources, Dr. Thomas Posado, Director of Pupil Personnel Services, Eleni Cronus, Assistant Director of Pupil Personnel Services, Chris Connors, Director of Instructional Technology, and Danielle Mamolito, Assistant Director of Instructional Technology. We also have our Searingtown School, led by Diana DiGregorio and Dan Salerno. Give it up for Searingtown. You have Center Street Elementary School with Principal Brennan Bierweiler and Assistant Principal Melissa Blady. And you also have your Denton Avenue Elementary School, the Denton Ducks, led by Principal Dominic Alpano and Assistant Principal Lily Ho. And don't forget about Herricks Middle School. Session, we have some of our department leaders, Meredith Maxim, Director of Social Studies K-12, Dr. Stephanie Knowles, Dr. Stephanie Knowles, Special Education, Karen Hughes, Director of Science and Technology, Dr. Michael Amandi, Director of English Reading Library K-12, James Irvis, Math K-12, and of course, Jim Patricka, Director of Athletics, Physical Education, and Health. Make sure to draw your attention to the south side of the football field, where we'll honor some of our senior football and cheerleaders and their parents, along with our special dignitaries. I'd also like to introduce the high school assistant principals, Andrew Prezone and Brian Hodge. And up next from Herricks High School, you have the freshman class of 2027. Give it up again for your freshman of Herricks High School. Following up next, you have your class of 2026, the sophomores. Make sure again to get loud for your sophomores.
also like to thank our faculty advisors for the freshman class of 2027, Keith Preston and Caroline Barrett, as well as our sophomore class advisors, Sheena John and Julie Steiner. And up next, we have our juniors, the class of 2025. The faculty advisors for the juniors, the class of 2025, are Kevin Cabot and Andrew Muller. Once again, give it up for your Herricks class of 2025, the juniors. And now, make sure to give it up for your seniors, the class of 2024. Faculty advisors for the seniors, class of 2024, are Charles Luisi and Tara Sheets. Once again, give it up for your seniors. I'd like to thank our Herricks High School student government, whose faculty advisor is also Michael Stein.
Thank you. welcome. If you please turn your attention to the far end zone, we have some special guests we'd like to announce. Some local special dignitaries. We have Councilwoman Lurvy here. Councilwoman Lurvy. State Assemblywoman Gina Saletti. Supervisor Jenna DeSena. Town Clerk Regina Silva. And Councilman Peter Zuckerman. Give these local dignitaries a big round of applause. Next up, we'd like to thank the people who helped make this possible, your Board of Education. President Jim Guinness. Vice President Henry Zanetti. Trustee Julie Chin. Trustee Nancy Feinstein. She's not here right now. And Trustee Brian Hassan. And some other very special people, our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Tony Sinanis. Our Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Clay Elizabeth Gerson. Our Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources, Ms. Dina Magicomo. And our Assistant Superintendent of Business, Ms. Lisa Ratowski. Thanks for everything you do, and I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Patricka.
All right, let's give a round of applause to Mr. Hodge. Okay, at this time, we'll be announcing some more extra special people. The first group of individuals we're recognizing are truly the heart and soul of Herricks High School. Week in and week out, these girls have thrilled us with outstanding performances during football and basketball games. They perform some of the most difficult athletic feats. They make it look so easy, and they do it with great big smiles. Tonight, this wonderful group will thrill us once again as they perform their last homecoming game. We will miss you dearly. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the 2023 senior cheerleader. Sophia Cooney, escorted by Daniela and Jerry. Ellie Landros, escorted by Stacy, Socrates, and Frankie. Haley Orlando, escorted by Rebecca. And Lexi Ranallo, escorted by Maria and Nello. Let's give it up for our senior cheerleaders. On a hot sunny day in August of 2020, these boys put on their helmets and shoulder pads for the first time at Herricks High School. Now, 4 years later, they will put on the pads and play in their final homecoming game. The past 4 years have been an amazing journey for these individuals. We have seen them transform from ninth grade boys into fine young men. We thank you for allowing us to join you on this path. We will certainly miss you. Please welcome the 2023 senior football players. Benson Chen, escorted by Karen and Jackie. Damien Chu, escorted by Diana and Dennis. Gabe Cruz, escorted by Rizzy. Sean Curry, escorted by Colette and Brian. Samir Ibrahim, escorted by Sharon and Tufi. Jerome DeLucio, escorted by Michelle. Thomas Audio, escorted by Maria and Steve. Connor Griffith, escorted by Cheryl and Brent. Brian Keating, escorted by Stephanie and Michael. Alex Kim, escorted by Eric. Dylan Leong, escorted by Vivian and Christopher. Joe Manfredi, escorted by Michelle and Jim. Rishi Patel, escorted by Punjab and Jagdeep. AJ Pollock, escorted by Melissa and Mark. Ishmael, escorted by Uma and Mohammed. Drew Rosario, escorted by Ignacio and Yuyi. Herman Singh, escorted by Pam and Bobby. Joel Farajawar, escorted by Joy and Jeb. And Ethan Tran, escorted by Kate and Jimmy. Let's give it up for your senior football and cheerleaders.
Thank you. tengo muchas novias. Muchas novias. Hoy tengo a una, mañana a otra. Me la voy a llevar a todas con VIP, VIP. Ay, saludos a ti. En Nicole ya confía, mi primera novia en Kinder María y mi primera amor se llamaba Talía. Tengo una colombiana que me sirve todos los días y una mexicana que ni yo sabía. Otra en San Antonio que me quiere todavía y la TPR que te gusta son mías.
I've been f***ing on the French, said I beat. I just put them on a jet, now they all Italian. Way I'm dressed until I been to $1,000. This is not about getting shots, but she's still a stallion. She don't even get a joke, but she's still smiling. Every night, late night, like I'm Jimmy Fallon. Pro shoot from anywhere, like you Ray Allen. Cody, turn me up. Cody, turn me up. Cody, turn me up.
My body, tagged in my pink Bob Marley. I got a whole army as Charlie. Get a killer, he the Joker, I'm Harley. I'm chunky, baby. Me on me, the Tanya. At least P.I. stand for you and for 30 Tanya.
We have our Highlander 10. Students from our senior class who were voted by their peers as those who best represent the spirit of the Highlander. Throughout their school career, these students have exemplified outstanding character, work ethic, spirit, and service. We appreciate their contribution and please join us in honoring them today. Jocelyn Chu. Devinder Chopra. Benjamin Hogan, Dylan Kocher, Alyssa Marciano. Brianna Matthews. Ishmael Ryan. Sasha Stern. Tristan Tarajbali. And Ethan Tran. Once again, we'd like to give it up for all voted members of our Highlander 10. And once again, thank you to their faculty advisors, Charles Luisi and Tara Sheets. Both at home and abroad, with our national anthem, sung by student performers Nicole Gallagher and Brianna Matthews. Direct. direct your attention to midfield for the Herricks alma mater.
Children making their own unique bracelets.
Ball spotted on the 23-yard line. Pass intended for the 14, Stephen Wright. Incomplete. Ball spotted on the 23-yard line. Pass intended for the 14, Stephen Wright. Incomplete. Number 14, Stephen Weiss with the reception. Number 14, Stephen Weiss with the reception.
Thank you.
headed for number 14, Stephen Lake. Headed for number 14, Stephen Lake. Number 28 with a tackle, Barraza. Number 28 with a tackle, Barraza. Number 28 with the interception for Roslyn. Number 28 with the interception for Roslyn. First and 10 on the 46-yard line for Roslyn. Flags down on the play. First and 10 on the 46-yard line for Roslyn. Flags down on the play. 28 with the run. Number 34, Frank Piscotty with the Rucks. Number 34, Frank Piscotty with the Rucks. Thank you.
Number two. Number two. First down, Highlanders, number eight. First down, Highlanders, number eight.
10, 48 yards.
Number one, Aziz.
10, 48 yards.
Number one, Aziz. Second and three. Cameron's extra point is good for the Highlanders. Cameron's extra point is good for the Highlanders.
Number 9, David Schmidt, takes it in. Number 9, David Schmidt, takes it in. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Number 14, Stephen Weiss with a rush. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Number 14, Stephen Weiss with a rush. Number 14, Stephen Weiss. To the Roslyn first down. Four set of bounds. Number 4, Samir Ibrahim. And number 5, Joseph Manfred. Number 14, Stephen Weiss, to the Roslyn first down. Four set of bounds, to number 4, Samir Ibrahim, and number 5, Joseph Manfred. Number 28 with a rush for Roslyn. Number 28 with a rush for Roslyn. Yard loss on the play. Six-yard loss on the play. Pass broken up by number 20. Pass broken up by number 20. Thank you. flags down on the play. Number six, Connor Griffin, with a return. Flag down on the play. Number six, Connor Griffin, with a return. Flag down on the play. First and 10, ball me 28 yards. First and 10, ball me 28 yards. She's camera, it is in. Pass the ticket for number one. She's camera, it is in. For Sean Curry. Yeah.
Couple pass number 44, Sean Curry. Both of them. Number 34, Frank. Pass intended for number 34, Frank. Second and 10 for the Bulldogs. For the Bulldogs. Three pass brings up third down. Maybe number 32. Maybe number 32. Thank you.
Returning by number 14, Stephen Weiss. Returning by number 14, Stephen Weiss. Complete blast by Rosalind. And for number four, Ethan. Yep. There's a tenant for number four, Ethan. Yep. On the 32-yard line. Thank you. Ball will be spotted on the 32-yard line. Number 8, Ethan Tran recovers the ball. Number 8, Ethan Tran recovers the ball. Number 8, Ethan Tran. Number 8, Ethan Tran. Thank you. Tackle made by number 32. Number 32, second and goal. Second and goal. Yard to go. One yard to go. Number 8, Preston Torres. Cruz with her cover. Gabe Cruz with a recovery. Frank Muscati with a tackle for Ready for number 28. a good. Here she can on the 45-yard line. Put it on. Kenny for number 28. No good. Push out.
Maria Roslin swallowed up by the Herricks team. Thank you. First and 10 on the 44-yard line for the Highlanders. Tram swallowed up by number 36. Joel, the lead. First and 10 on the 44-yard line for the Highlanders. Tram swallowed up by number 36. Joel, the lead. Cameron's extra point for the Highlanders is good. Give it up for your cheerleaders. Support for the Highlanders is good. That concludes the third quarter of Cards. Snapchat is still open, folks. Make sure to get your snaps before the night is over. Snapchat is still open on the north side. That's the center for number four, Ethan Yetman. That's the center for number four, Ethan Yetman. Number 34 of Ascani is incomplete. tackle made by number 80, Kaylee. Made by number 80, Kaylee. With a return. First down, Highlanders, Alex King. First down, Highlanders. Alex King.
Rush by number 11, Trishti Patel.